We have been looking over several years into drug services provided to people in prison settings in Europe, and we have seen some progress in a number of countries in the provision of these services, but there is still a huge gap between a situation outside of prison and inside, in particular when we talk about substitution treatment, where we know half of Europe's users are in this type of treatment. And until recently, there were still countries who did not provide it in prison settings. We know from evidence that this treatment is effective just as outside prisons. It reduces the use of illicit heroin, and it also reduces the risk of drug overdose if it is continued after release. Many countries in Europe have scaled up the provision of this in the context of their other harm reduction services, and we see opioid substitution treatment as one of the important services that opioid-dependent prisoners need, because with an average in incarceration period of 8 months in Europe, we know that prison sentences for drug users often are very short, and it would be a very high risk to detoxify them and let them go back to the community detoxified, because there is a very high risk of drug-related death after release from prison that is scientifically very strongly documented. So some countries also allow people to get back on opioid substitution treatment when they are just before release in order to continue the treatment with the external community-based services. So from the experience in Europe, we have only scarce data on the provision, but we know that in some countries, more than 10% of the prisoner population is receiving this treatment.